my friend John Messler here earlier. And I just, this, you know, folks, sometimes just one random act of kindness can change a person's life. Now, this gentleman, John Messler, years back in 1979, when I finished college, I moved to Nashville for a while, and I couldn't make a go out of it, though. And so I'd been there about 5 months, and I was about to move to New York City. And so the thing that I loved the most about Nashville at that time was this club called the Station Inn. It's still there. It's a bluegrass club. So I was there, and I was sitting in with one of my heroes, who's still alive, luckily. His name's Roland White. He's a mandolin player, and he's the brother of the late Clarence White. And I just loved their records together. And so anyway, gentleman was there with a couple of friends, and he was talking to Roland, and Roland said, well, hey, why don't you do a few? And so they got up and did some songs, and they did a Graham Parsons song. And I went over to this fellow and introduced himself, and it was John. So his name is John Messler, and he said he lived up in New Jersey. And well, he'll send it to you, too, because I want you to. And so I said, well, shoot, I'm getting ready to move up to New York City in a couple of weeks. Do you know any place I could play? And he said, well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to call a guy at this club called O'Lunny's. Anybody else ever go there? It's not around anymore. Where was that, John?
Second Avenue,
like 47th or something like that. It was the first country bar in New York. And he said, look, you know, probably it'll be like a solo gig playing between the sets of a band. You know, but I was like, oh gosh, that'd be fantastic if I could get it. So sure enough, he lined that up for me. And so I did. I went out there, and that was a huge thing for me. And there that first night was Larry Campbell was playing steel with a guy, and it was he called it the Frogman Band. Remember? And so you know, I met Larry, and then Larry ended up playing with Buddy Miller. But just from playing at O'Lunny's, then I kind of started branching, you know, networking out a little bit and started getting some gigs. But if it wasn't for that, I don't know if I would have started gigging in New York, you know, while I was living there. And hey, things might have turned out totally different, you know. So I can't thank you enough. What's that?
I think you would have been fine. Anyway.
I don't think so. You know, I mean, that gig was kind of the gateway gig for me. And so John, you know, and it's, we're like, you know, brothers in a lot of ways. And, you know, it's funny how music can really be this great bond between people. So thank you. And one night, John said, and we wrote a couple of things together, and one time he said, hey, come out to the shore, I've got this place. Where was it?
South Seaside Park, Midway Beach.
Midway Beach. So I think I took a train or something, or maybe came out. At Point Pleasant, yeah. And we stayed up all night long working on this song, with a little help from, luckily the kids that were here are gone. But anyway, we wrote this song together, John and I, so I want to do it now. Thank you. in the haze. Got someone said she'll be there on the haze. Lord, I hope she can't find me, 'cause I think I've lost my way. Never made. So